अस्सलाम वालेकुम क्लास 9, वेलकम टू अल मुनीर हाई स्कूल ई लर्निंग सिस्टम। क्लास 9, दिस इज़ योर यूनिट नंबर 8, फिजिक्स, थर्मल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मैटर। दिस इज़ द टाइटल पेज ऑफ योर फिजिक्स बुक फॉर क्लास 9। टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज़ अबाउट थर्मल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मैटर। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू हैव टू नो अबाउट the temperature and the heat. What is temperature and what is heat? Here definitions are given that temperature of a body is the degree of hotness and or coldness of the body. So a candle flame is hot and is said to be at high temperature. Ice on the other hand is cold and is said to be at low temperature. So our sense of touch is simple way to know how much cold or hot a body is. So it is all about the temperature and the hotness and the coldness of the body. Next students, we have two terms, thermal contact and thermal equilibrium. What is thermal contact? Contact to store ice in summer, people wrap it with cloth or keep it in wooden box or in thermos flask. In this way, they avoid the thermal contact of ice with its hot surroundings, otherwise ice will soon melt away. Similarly, when you place a cup of hot tea or water in a room, it cools down gradually because does it continue cooling? No, it stops cooling as it reaches the room temperature. So this is called the thermal equilibrium. Next, we have the definition of heat. What is heat? Heat is the energy that is transferred from one body to the other in thermal contact with each other as a result of the difference of temperature between them. Also, we have some internal energy. Internal energy is the sum of kinetic energy and potential energy associated with the atoms, molecules and particles of a body is called its internal energy. Yes, internal energy depends on many factors such as mass of the body, kinetic and potential energies of the molecules. Kinetic energy of an atom or molecule is due to its motion, which depends upon the temperature. What is thermometer? A device that is used to measure the temperature is called a thermometer. Some substances have property that change with temperature. Substances that show a change with temperature can be used as a thermometric material. For example, some substances expand on heating, some change their colors, some change their electric resistance. Nearly all the substances expand on heating. Liquids also expand on heating and are suitable as thermometric materials. Common thermometers are generally made using some suitable liquid as a thermometric material. So a thermometric liquid should have the following properties. So here we have the properties: should be visible, should have uniform thermal expansion, have a low freezing point, high boiling point, not wet glass, should be a good conductor of heat, should have a small specific heat capacity. Here we have the liquid in glass thermometer, students. A liquid in glass thermometer has a bulb with a long capillary tube of uniform and fine bore. A suitable liquid is filled in the bulb. When the bulb contacts a hot object, the liquid in it expands and rises in the tube. The glass stamp of a thermometer is a thick and act as a cylindrical lens. Look here. Here we have a picture of a mercury glass thermometer. Mercury freezes at minus 39 degrees centigrade and boils at 357 degrees centigrade. We can check the lower and upper fixed points. A thermometer has a scale on its stem. This scale has two fixed points. The lower fixed point is marked to show the position of liquid in the thermometer when it is placed in ice. Similarly, upper fixed point is marked to show the position of liquid in the thermometer when it is placed in steam of at standard pressure above boiling point. Also, we have different scales, students. Scales of thermometer. A scale is marked on the thermometer. The temperature of a body in contact with the thermometer can be read on that scale. So here, students, we have different scales. Celsius scale, Fahrenheit scale, and Kelvin scale. On Celsius scale, the interval between lower and upper fixed points is divided into 100 equal parts, and the lower fixed point is marked as 0 degree centigrade, and the upper fixed point is marked as 100 degree centigrade. On Fahrenheit scale, the interval between lower and upper fixed points is divided into 180 equal parts. Its lower fixed point is marked as 32 degree Fahrenheit, and upper fixed point is marked as 212 degree Fahrenheit. So the SI units of temperature is the Kelvin, and its scale is called Kelvin scale of temperature, as shown in figure 8.3. Yes, we can convert the temperature from one scale to another scale. The temperature T on Kelvin scale can be obtained by adding 273 in the temperature of C on Celsius scale. So here we have the formula to change the temperature from Celsius to the Kelvin scale. And these examples shows these conversions. Yes, also we can convert it from Fahrenheit to Celsius scale, students. Here formula is given. Next, students, our topic is about the specific heat capacity. Specific heat of a substance is the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of 1 kilogram of mass of that substance through 1 Kelvin. So here 1 Kelvin is the temperature, 1 kilogram is the mass. So how much amount of heat is required? It is denoted by delta Q over mass into change in temperature. So C shows the specific heat capacity, and the SI unit of mass is M, is measured is kilogram, change in heat is measured in joules, and temperature, yes, the unit of temperature is the Kelvin. So when we add all these three units, we will get the unit of specific heat capacity, which will be joules, kilograms, Kelvin. What is the importance of large specific heat capacity of water? Specific heat of water is 4200, and that of dry soil is about 810. As a result, the temperature of soil would increase 5 times more than the same mass of water by the same amount of heat. So the temperature of land rises and falls more rapidly than that of the sea. Hence, the temperature variations from summer to winter are much smaller at places near the sea than land far away from the sea. Water has a large specific heat capacity. For this reason, it is very useful in storing and carrying thermal energy due to its high specific heat capacity. The cooling systems of automobiles uses water to carry away unwanted thermal energy. So all these are the applications and importance. Look here, we have example number 8.3. A container has 2.5 liters, volume is given, mass is given, specific heat of water is given, initial temperature, final temperature is given, change in temperature is given. We have to put all these values in this formula, Q is equal to C M delta T, to find out the amount of heat. Heat capacity, what is heat capacity, students? Heat capacity of a body is the quantity of thermal energy observed by it for 1 Kelvin increase in its temperature. So delta Q over delta T shows the heat capacity. So heat capacity will be equal to mass into specific heat capacity. Yes, we can change of state. Matter can be changed from one state to another. For such a change to occur, thermal energy is added to or removed from a substance. Here we have the activity 8.1. Take a beaker and place it over a stand. Put some pieces of ice in the beaker. Suspend a thermometer in the beaker to measure the temperature of ice. Now place a burner under the beaker. The ice will start melting. The temperature of the mixer containing ice and water will not increase above 0 degree centigrade until all the ice melts and we get water at 0 degree centigrade. If this water at 0 degree centigrade is further heated, its temperature will begin to increase above 0 degree centigrade. Next topic is latent heat of fusion. Yes, heat energy required to change unit mass of a substance from solid to liquid state at its melting point without change in its temperature is called latent heat of fusion. Yes, here we have the formula. HF is equal to change in heat F over mass. experiment number 8.1 shows the latent heat of fusion. Take a beaker and place it over stand. Put some pieces of ice in the beaker and suspend a thermometer. It is same as we have studied above. Continue heating the water at 0 degrees centigrade in the beaker. Its temperature will begin to increase or rise. So through this activity, time is given, time taken to melt, time taken by water to heat, specific heat of water is given, increase in the temperature of water is given, heat required by water from 0 degree centigrade to 100 degree centigrade is, we can calculate it with the same formula by putting the values. So rate of observing heat will be given, heat observed in time is given. Since putting by putting the values, we will get the values of T1 and TO can be found from the graph. Put the values in the above equation to get the latent heat of fusion. Next we have the latent heat of vaporization. The quantity of heat that changes unit mass of a liquid completely into gas at its boiling point without any change in its temperature is called its latent heat of vaporization. It is denoted by HV. Its formula is change in heat of vaporization over mass. Yes, when water is heated, it boils at 100 degree centigrade. Its temperature remains 100 degree centigrade until it is completely converted into steam. So its latent heat of vaporization is 2.26 into 10 ki power 5 joules kilograms. So this blue table shows the different substances, their melting points, boiling points, heat of fusion and heat of vaporization. This graph shows the temperature time graph shows the ice change into water and water into the steam as we have studied above. What is evaporation, students? Evaporation is the changing of a liquid into vapors, gaseous state from the surface of the liquid without heating it. Unlike boiling, evaporation takes place at all temperatures, but only from the surface of a liquid. The process of boiling takes place at a certain fixed temperature, which is the boiling point of that liquid. At boiling point, a liquid is changing into vapors, not only from the surface, but also within the liquid. These vapors come out of the boiling liquid as bubbles, which break down on reaching its surface. So evaporation plays an important role in our daily life. Wet clothes dry up rapidly when spread. Evaporation causes cooling. Why? During evaporation, fast moving molecules escape out from the surface of the liquid. Next we have some factors which depend on the evaporation. Temperature. Yes, at high temperature, more molecules of a liquid are moving with high velocities. So more molecules escape from its surface. Evaporation is faster at higher temperature than at low temperature. Surface area, larger is the surface area of a liquid, greater number of molecules has the chance to escape from its surface. Wind blowing over the surface of a liquid sweeps away the liquid molecules that have just escaped out. And the nature of the liquid. Yes, spread a few drops of a ether or spray on your palm, you feel cold, because it evaporates rapidly. Thermal expansion. Most of the substances, solid, liquid or gases, expand on heating and contract on cooling. Their thermal expansions and contractions are usually small and are not noticeable. However, these expansions and contractions are important in our daily life. The kinetic energy of the molecules of an object depends on its temperature. The molecules of a solid vibrate with larger amplitude at higher temperature than at low temperature. On cooling, heating, the amplitude of vibrations of the atoms or molecules of an object increases. They push one another further away as the amplitude of vibration increases. Next we have linear thermal expansion in solids. Students, we know that if we heat a rod, iron rod, it will expand, its length will increase. We will show it by this equation, due to increase in temperature. So change in length is directly proportional to original length into change in temperature. So here we have the alpha. This is the coefficient of linear thermal expansion of a substance. So here we have the formula of the alpha, change in length over original length multiplied by change in temperature. We can, yes, if all these values are given, we can calculate the latent, the value of the alpha. कॉफिशेंट ऑफ लेंथ. वॉल्यूम थर्मल एक्सपेंशन, यस वॉल्यूम ऑल्सो इंक्रीज विद द इंक्रीज इन टेम्परेचर. सो चेंज इन द वॉल्यूम ऑफ ए सॉलिड, चेंज इन टेम्परेचर, वी नो दैट चेंज इन वॉल्यूम इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू ओरिजिनल वॉल्यूम इन टू चेंज इन टेम्परेचर. सो हेयर वी हैव द कॉन्स्टेंट बीटा. बीटा शोज द कॉफिशियंट ऑफ वॉल्यूम एक्सपेंशन. सो हेयर वी हैव द फॉर्मूला ऑफ बीटा, चेंज इन वॉल्यूम ओवर ओरिजिनल वॉल्यूम इन टू चेंज इन टेम्परेचर. सो वी कैन डिफाइन द टेम्परेचर कॉफिशियंट ऑफ वॉल्यूम एक्सपेंशन बीटा एज अ फ्रैक्शनल चेंज इन इट्स वॉल्यूम पर केल्विन चेंज इन टेम्परेचर. So here we have the example 8.7. If all these values are given, we can calculate the value of beta by putting all these values. What are the consequences of thermal expansion? Why gaps are left in railway tracks? The expansion of solids may damage the bridges, railway tracks and roads as they are constantly subjected to temperature change. So provision is made during construction or for expansion and contraction with temperature. For example, railway tracks buckled on a hot summer day due to expansion if gaps are not left between sections. Bridges made of steel girders also expand during the day and contract during night as shown in this figure. So they will bend if their ends are fixed. To allow thermal expansion, one end is fixed while the other end of the girder rests on the rollers on the gap left for expansion. What are the applications of thermal expansion? Thermal expansion is used in our daily life in thermometers. Thermal expansion is used in temperature measurements. To open the cap of a bottle that is tight enough, immerse it in hot water for a minute or so, metal cap expands and becomes loose. To join steel plates tightly together, red hot rivets are forced through holes in the plates as shown in figure 8.18. Look here students, these are the bolts. So iron rims are fixed on wooden wheels of cars. Iron rims are heated. Thermal expansion allows them to slip over the wooden wheel. Water is poured on it to cool. The rim contracts and becomes tight over the wheel. Last topic, we have the bimetallic strip consists of two thin strips of different metals, brass and iron, joined together as shown in figure 8.19. So here we have the picture of brass. Yes, it expands on heating. Bimetal strips are used for various purposes. Yes, bimetal thermometers are used to measure the temperatures, especially furnaces and ovens. Bimetal strips are also used in thermostats in air conditioning. Thermal expansions of liquids. The molecules of liquids are free to move in all directions within the liquid. On heating a liquid, the average amplitude of vibration of its molecules increases. The molecules push each other and need more space to occupy. This accounts for the expansion of a liquid when heated. The thermal expansion in liquids is greater than solids due to the weak forces between their molecules. The coefficient of volume expansion of liquids is greater than solids. Liquids have no definite shape of their own. A liquid always attains shape of the container in which it is poured. When a liquid is heated, both liquid and the container undergo a change in their volume. There are two types of thermal volume expansion of a liquid, apparent and real. Do you know? Water on cooling below 4 degrees centigrade begins to expand until it reaches to 0 degrees centigrade. So students, this is all for today. In the last, we have the activity. Take a long necked flask, fill it with some colored liquid up to mark A. So here we have the mark A on its neck. Now start heating the flask from the bottom. The liquid level first falls to B here and then rises to C. The heat first reaches the flask, which expands and its volume increases. As a result, liquid descends in the flask and its level falls to B. After some time, the liquid begins to rise above B. On getting hot at certain temperature, it reaches at C. The rise in level from A to C is due to the apparent expansion in the volume of the liquid. Actual expansion of the liquid is greater than that due to the expansion because of the expansion of glass floss. The real expansion of a liquid is equal to the volume difference between A and C in addition to volume expansion. So BC is equal to AC plus AB. So the expansion of the volume of a liquid, taking into consideration the expansion of the container, also is called the real volume expansion of the liquid. So students, we can say that beta is always greater than the apparent rate of volume expansion. So by an amount equal to the rate of volume expansion of the container. So it should be noted that different liquids have different coefficient of volume expansion. So this is all for today. Thank you. Allah Hafiz.